Welcome to the second 50 years is the slogan that greets visitors to the AFO Foundation website. It's a slogan that distills and elucidates the deepest passions of its founder, Harold Baptiste, who, in addition to a long list of profound accomplishments and accolades, has made it his mission to catalog and promote the musical creations of New Orleans' finest modern jazz composers and musicians. The son of a tailor, Mr. Baptiste's career began as an educator when he graduated from Dillard University in 1952.
My first job was a little teaching job up in Durrell, Louisiana. I had trouble with the systems, with segregation and all of the stuff that was going on at that time. And they offered me a choice of whether I could comply with what the supervisors wanted or I could resign.
Drummer Ed Blackwell and Ornette Coleman had become friends in New Orleans. Harold, Ellis Marcellus, and Ed Blackwell hitched up the wagons and headed west.
Ornette Coleman had sent Blackwell a ticket to come out to California.
I had just finished from Dillard University and was literally doing nothing. I was thinking, if Ed was going up there, I think I might just go with him.
So I said, well, look, you can cash that ticket and I can take my car out there and the three of us go.
So we got in Harold Baptiste's car and drove all the way to Los Angeles.
Says I got out to California.
Harold began visiting record labels in search of a record deal, eventually getting hired to arrange what would become a classic session for Bumps Blackwell at Art Roop's Specialty Records.
He was about to record Sam Cooke, and I happened to go by there with my Ornette Coleman stuff. So Bumps Blackwell said, look, man, I ain't got time for that, but right now, if you can help me get this thing together like that, I can check it out. And so he sent me in with Sam to find a B-side. I didn't find it. Sam just had you send me among the tunes that he had written, and he was playing them all for me. So I began to see what was happening on the inside of the music business. I came back to New Orleans and I had an office.
During this period, he had an epiphany that led to the formation of AFO Records and Atlas Publishing, the first all-black and musician-owned companies of their kind in the U.S.
When I was about 12 years old, I went to his office, which was down the street and across the street from where I used to live. And I sung for him. I thought he was going to sign me up. I didn't know. I was just singing. I wanted to sing. And he told me I sung okay, but I was a little bit too young.
AFO would go on to produce major hits by the likes of Barbara George and record the earliest records by New Orleans' finest contemporary jazz artists.
There was probably no recording company in the South, period. That was trying to do anything with a serious jazz recording. That felt really good.
Eventually, Harold would return to L.A., producing several gold records for Sonny and Cher and becoming one of the first African-American musical directors of a major national television show. But in 1989, he would receive a call to return to his roots back home, once again as an educator.
And one of the first people I wanted on the faculty was Harold. So I called Harold and asked him if he would come to, be on the faculty.
And I had already started doing some teaching out in Los Angeles. I had, lectures. I would go to UCLA and go to various campuses, and I was beginning to re-enjoy the idea of teaching.
Once home, he decided to transform the AFO name from record label to not-for-profit foundation. A major accomplishment of the AFO Foundation is the publishing of the Silver Book, an authoritative compilation of jazz compositions that welcomes you to the second 50 years of New Orleans jazz. Never relinquishing his role as educator and mentor, he continues to inspire and push young talent toward excellence.
Having mentors like Harold Baptiste, for me, was a monumental step in between when you make a bad decision and a good decision about your life.
Harold was always a guiding force. He was always championing jazz music.
He's done a lot for New Orleans, for the musicians of New Orleans. He came back home and became a teacher, and I'm sure his students were very happy that he did. And if he did anything teaching them the way he coached me when I came to him as a 12-year-old, I'm sure they are very, very happy that he came into their lives in that capacity.
I don't know where I would be without, you know, Bat's help and inspiration and understanding, and there's tons of adjectives that describe him. If you get to know him, that's what I would say, you know, you really get to understand the man better and know why people love him.
For a man who has seen and done it all, what does the future hold?
Well, I'm going to try to get that saxophone fixed up. See that one sitting right over there?